So she took out the first matchstick and burned, and she had the vision of a stove, a burning stove that was very bright. When she burned the second matchstick, she had the transparent view through a wall, and she saw a dining table which was filled with edible things, and the most desired thing of hers, the roasted goose, was seen on the table, and to her surprise, it started to hop, jump out of the table with the spoons and forks in its back, and with a knife which is used to cut the goose, and started to walk towards her. Then the vision disappeared. Then we were looking at the third matchstick and the third vision. What was the third vision? The third vision was that of a Christmas tree. She very much desired to have a Christmas tree, and she had seen one in the last Christmas time from the window, glass window of a shop, a beautiful Christmas tree. Now, when she struck the third matchstick, she had that vision, the vision of a beautiful, wonderful, excellent Christmas tree. So that's where we stopped. We'll get back to it. Page number 90. She struck another match, and suddenly she was sitting under the most beautiful Christmas tree. It was much larger and much lovelier than the one she had seen last year through the glass doors of the rich merchant's house. This was better than what she had seen and desired. A thousand candles lit up the green branches and gaily colored balls like those in the shop windows looked down upon her. And there were so many lights around the tree. On the tree there were so many lights. A thousand candles lit up the green branches. A thousand. It's an exaggeration. It's an exaggeration. Hyperbole. A thousand candles lit up on the branches of the Christmas tree. Is it possible to lit up thousand candles on the Christmas tree? It is impossible. And even if it's possible, how do you know it is a thousand? It's an exaggeration. That means many, many. Humpty, big number, large number of candles were lit up on the Christmas tree. And what else was there? And gaily colored balls like those in the shop windows looked down upon her. Gaily means bright or pretty colored, bright colored. So colorful balls. Normally on the Christmas tree, you'll find some colorful balls. I'll show you something like this. So it will be just like this. Here, this will be a colorful one. Like that, no? So there will be so many balls like this hanging on the Christmas tree. You have seen the crib, I told you, no? You used to come to the campus to see, look at the crib. On the crib, you'll find on the Christmas tree, there will be a lot of glittering lights, bulbs, balls. The little girl reached forward with both hands. Then out went the match. So they were just looking at her. These balls were just looking at her, and she was attracted. The little girl reached forward with both the hands. She wanted to take hold of them, catch them. Then out went the match. Matchstick went off, extinguished. The many candles on the Christmas tree rose higher and higher. through the air, and she saw that they had now turned into bright stars. Oh, wonderful, wonderful. She wanted to just get hold of some of them. Just about to hold them, then suddenly they disappeared. Then what happened? Out went the match. The vision is over. The many candles on the Christmas tree rose higher and higher through the air, and she saw that they had now turned into bright stars. So the balls disappeared. She wanted to have it, but she could not, because the matchstick went off. But there is something happened, something miraculous happened there. We were told that there were thousands of candles on the Christmas tree. So, suppose this is a Christmas tree. So, there were so many candles burning. All these candles, they started to rise and rise and rise. They all turned into stars. The candles on the Christmas tree rose higher and higher through the air. And she saw that they had now turned into bright stars. One of them fell, streaking the sky with light. All of them were going up, all the candles. As they went up, they all turned out into stars. They all became stars in the sky. And one of them fell. All the rest went up higher and higher. Only one fell from the sky. How did it fall? One of them fell, streaking the sky with light. So it's a kind of small explosion, like there was a big light when it fell. You must have heard about shooting stars falling, that fall. Okay. Now somebody is dying, said the little girl, for her old grandmother, the only one who had ever been good to her, but who was now dead, had said, whenever a star falls, a soul goes up to God. This is a small paragraph, but it's significant. It's important. Because it is also the part of the vision connected with the third vision. So when all the candles went up, turned into stars and went up the sky, only one star fell. That falling of the star is very symbolic. I told you in the beginning, the author uses a lot of imageries, lot of symbols. They stand for something more than that. Falling stars, the shooting stars are representative of something else. They are not just stars. They are representing or they are telling us something more about something else. Now someone is dying, said the little girl, for her old grandmother, the only one who had ever been good to her, but who was now dead, had said, whenever a star falls, a soul goes up to God. She was not loved by many. How was her mother? We do not know. We are not told. We have only information about her mother is that she was, the little girl was having the slippers of her mother on her feet. And it was too big for her. Only that much is said. How was her mother? Is she there? Was she good to her? We do not know. But her father was very cruel, very strict. He wanted her to earn money. That's all. So therefore, she had nobody at home to love her. Only there was one who cared for her. There was only one person whom she liked, and that was her grandmother. And she is no more. She is dead and gone. When she was alive, when she was with her, once she had told her that whenever a star falls, a soul goes up to God. is this in double inverted comma. That is said by the grandmother. Whenever a star falls, a soul goes up to God. So falling stars, they are imageries. It's an imagery of a soul, a person dying and going up to God. Therefore, she concludes, a star has fallen, another star has risen. One star falls, another person, one soul goes up to heaven, up to God. So that is about the third vision. Yesterday I told you there are altogether four visions. She stuck another match on the wall. Once more, there was light, and in the glow stood her old grandmother. Oh, so bright and shining, and looking so gentle, kind and loving. Granny, cried the little girl, oh, take me with you. I know you will disappear when the match is burnt out. You will vanish like the warm star, the lovely roast goose, and the great glorious Christmas tree. So these were the four visions she had. For every vision, every matchstick she stuck. Every matchstick she burned, she had a vision. The first one was burning stove. Second one was roasted goose. Third one was Xmas, means Christmas. Christmas tree. And the fourth one was a grandmother herself. See, look at the hierarchy. This is the first one, then there's the second one, third one. This is not in the hierarchic order, it is vice versa. What was now the first vision was burning stove. That was the immediate need was warmth and comfort. Then roasted goose, she wanted something to eat. Then it was Christmas tree, that fascinates or satisfies her desire of having a Christmas tree and what she had seen at the shop's window. And the most desired thing was grandmother, the comfort she enjoyed with her grandmother, the only one used to love her. So now she strikes the fourth matchstick and she has the vision of the grandmother. She struck another match on the wall. Once more there was light, and in the glow stood her old grandmother, who was so bright and shining. The grandma was shining, very colorful, bright. And looking so gentle, kind, and loving. She was gentle. What were the qualities of grandmother? She was gentle, kind, and loving. And that is what she lacked in her life. She wanted people to love her. She wanted someone to care for her. She wanted somebody to show concern for her. But that was missing. Only grandmother was concerned about her. And when she saw grandma, she shouted, Granny, my dear granny, you have come. I'm so happy. Oh, take me with you. I know you will disappear when the match is burnt out. You will vanish like the warm stove, the lovely roast goose, and the great glorious Christmas tree. So from the experience, now she knows that the vision does not stay for long. The vision happens when she lights a match. How long will it stay? As long as the matchstick is burning. The moment the matchstick is extinguished, it goes off, the vision will disappear. So she says, I know that you also will disappear when the match goes off, just like the burning stove that disappeared, the roasted goose that went away, the Christmas tree that is no more with me. So you also will disappear. But I want to stay with you. Therefore, please take me along with you. Then she quickly struck all the rest of the matches she had in the packet. For she did so, want to keep her grandmother with her. This is a climax of the story. Her meeting with her grandmother is the climax of the story. You know, last time, I don't know whether you have, I had sent the video on the short story. What are the characteristics of a short story? If you have read it and remember, every story should have a climax. That is the topmost point, the peak point. So the peak point, she has reached the peak point, or the story has reached the climax now when she meets the grandmother. And there is some lot of action is being done. So far she was striking one matchstick. And now she takes all the matchsticks and strikes. She burns all the matchsticks one by one. Why? Because she knows her grandmother also will disappear like the other visions. So she wanted to make her grandmother to stay with her as long as possible. In order to make her to stay with her, or in order to stay with her some more time, she started to burn all the matches. Then she quickly struck all the rest of the matches she had in the packet. For she did so, want to keep her grandmother with her. The matches flared up with such a blaze that it was brighter than broad daylight. And her old grandmother had never seemed so beautiful or so stately before. She took the little girl in her arms and flew with her high up, oh, so high, towards the glory and joy. Now they knew neither. They knew neither cold nor hunger or fear, for they were both with God. Beautiful. So when she said, please take me away, grandmother is so loving. I think you... How many of you do not like your grandparents, grandfather and grandmother? Most of the children like grandfather and grandmother, sometimes more than your parents. I know. Number of students, especially when you are in up to school level, you like the grandparents. You love them more than those who are your parents are less liked compared to your likeness to your grandparents. A number of cases, not all of you, some have more love for parents. So anyway, little Madge here had a great admiration and love for her grandmother. So when she requested her to take her along with grandmother, grandmother took it very seriously. The matches flared up with such a blaze that it was brighter than broad daylight. What is flare up? F-L-A-R-E. Flare up means a sudden outburst. It's like a small bomb. A small bomb. A cracker, what you use in Diwali? In Diwali time, you use crackers. It flares up. Flare up means suddenly, sudden outburst. And what is blaze? A blaze is a large burning fire. A large burning fire. Blaze means to light up. Blaze. Blazing. The sun is blazing means sun shines with a lot of light. So blaze means a large burning fire like the sun. So there is a point of exaggeration. That's a point of exaggeration. Because you know that all of you must have tried burning the matchstick. How much light it gives? It gives light, of course. And if it is darkness, it shines well. But not so much like a bursting. Not so much like it does not become like a daylight. So there is a certain amount of exaggeration. But you have to look at the spirit of the child. The child was really happy. When she burned all the matches, it was filled with so much of light and sudden outburst of things. That is to say, she was excited. She was overjoyed. The matches flared up with such a blaze that it was brighter than broad daylight. So the matchstick which she burned was brighter than the sun shining. Is it possible? Not possible, but we have to look at in the right spirit. That is to say, she was overjoyed. And her grandmother had never seemed so beautiful or so stately before. Stately means the grand in look. Looking majestic or looking very grand, decorated, brightened. So she was, her grandmother looked so beautiful, so brightened before. That means today she looked extremely beautiful and charming. She took the little girl in her arms and flew with her high up. Oh, so high. Towards glory and joy. So she took her in the hand and started to fly. Just like the candles which flew into the thin air and became stars. Grandma took the little match girl in her hand and started to go up, up, up. How long or how much should she go? How far should she go? She went so high. Towards glory and joy. We have a belief that after our death, there will be something waiting for us, heaven. And all of us will be very joyful, very happy over there. So, based on that belief, it is said that the misery of the little child is coming and to an end. She is going to a place where there is no cold. There is no suffering. There is no deprivation. Everything will be very rosy, very attractive. So she went to the world of glory and joy. Now they knew neither cold, nor hunger, nor fear. Now they knew. They knew means who are the they? Who are the they now? So here they means both grandmother and the little child. Grandmother and the little child. They knew neither cold nor hunger nor fear, for they were both with God. When we are with God after our death, it is believed that it will be a time of joy. There is nothing to fear. There is nothing untoward happening. Everything is excellent. Everything is loving, joyful, glorious. So that was the state the little girl was enjoying. We'll come to the last but one paragraph. Last but one. But in the cold dawn, in the corner formed by the two houses, said the little girl with rosy cheeks and smiling lips. Dead, frozen to death on the last evening of the old year. The dawn of the new year rose on the huddled figure of the girl. She was still holding the matches, and half a packet had been burnt. But in the cold dawn, in the corner formed by the two houses, dawn. So you can learn this word if you do not know. Dawn, D-A-W-N, dawn is early morning. Suprabhat. Suprabhat. So early morning. Dusk is late evening, just before the sunset. This is at the sunrise, dawn. This is at the sunset, dusk. It's a phrase, not dawn to dusk. There are some students who study from dawn to dusk. The poor people work in the field from dawn to dusk. Early morning to evening. So, but in the cold dawn, early morning, which was very cold, you remember we left her, she was sitting in the corner formed by two houses, one jetting out in the street. There she was sitting there, and it was very cold. From there, we went off to the vision. She stuck the first match, she had the first vision, second one like that. Now we have come back to the same place where we met her earlier. We left her sitting at the corner of the two houses. Now we are coming back there. But in the cold dawn, in the corner formed by the two houses, sat the little girl with rosy cheeks and smiling lips. You remember earlier she was frustrated, she was unhappy, she was tired because of walking without a shoe on, without slippers. Now she has a different picture. She is looking very good. Sat the little girl with rosy cheek and smiling lips. Her lips were smiling. Elliot was sad, crying. And she had a rosy cheeks. Rosy cheeks means looking very, very handsome, blushing. Dead, frozen to death on the last evening of the old year. Sad thing. It was a wonderful sight to see her looking very good, smiling, and with a rosy cheek. But unfortunately, she was dead. She's no more. She died in the bitter cold of the night. Really sad. The dawn of the new year rose on the huddled figure of the girl. Already we told what is the meaning of huddled. We have seen that word in the first page, last paragraph. We have seen she huddled down in a heap in a corner formed by two houses. I already told you what is the meaning of huddled means to just fall like a heap. She just fell like that and she was sitting there. So she was still holding the dawn of the new year rose from the huddled figure of the girl. The dawn of the new year. That was the previous day when she walked, it was evening, the eve of the old year. Now the new year has risen. The sun is risen and the new year has come. The new year rose on the dead body of the girl. The girl is there dead, and the sun rose above her. bringing the new year. She was still holding the matches, and half a packet had been burnt. So she could burn only half a packet. The rest was there. And she was clutching it, holding it in her hands. Now the concluding paragraph. This is also important. This is a kind of a resolution. That's another characteristic of the story. Resolution. Conclusion of the story. She was evidently trying to warm herself, people said. But no one knew what beautiful visions she had seen and in what a blaze of glory she had ended with her dear old grandmother. Into the heavenly joy and gladness of a new year. She was evidently trying to warm herself, people said. That means, see, till now nobody cared for her. She was in the street trying to sell matches. Nobody bought even a single match. She earned not a penny. Nobody was worried about her. Now that she is dead and sitting in the corner, which formed by two houses, there were so many people coming around her. So many people came around her and they were all trying to find out what happened to her. Why she is there? Why she is dead? And people started to speak. And what did they say? She was evidently trying to warm herself. Evidently means seemingly. Seemingly. Evidence is there. What is evidence? Matchsticks are there. The burned matchsticks are there lying down. And she had plenty of matches. Half of them have been burned. And it was very cold night. Evidently, you can very easily conclude that she was trying to warm herself, they said. But no one knew what beautiful visions she had seen and what a blaze of glory she had ended with her dear old grandmother into the heavenly joy and gladness of a new year. Everyone who saw her might have regretted. Every person who saw her lying there dead, Bachchan said, what a poor child. What a poor child. She should not have died. Something that this sort should not have happened to her. That's what they will think. But nobody, why do they think so? Because nobody knew exactly what had happened to her. Was she happy to die? What do you say? Was she happy to die? Yes, she should have been very happy to die. Why? Because she has ended the heavenly joy. She has reached the place where she wanted to reach. She was fed up with this worldly life. She is afraid of her father. She is not willing to go out to sell matches. But now she is happy because she has seen her grandmother, the only person who loved her. And she wanted to go with her. She succeeded in going with her. And not only that, she got the greatest joy of going to heaven to be with God and there to enter the everlasting joy. So nobody knew the great visions she had. What are the great visions she had? The four visions. The vision kept on improving one by one. First one that's of a burning stove, then the roasted goose, then she had the Christmas tree, then the greatest vision and the wonderful vision of her grandma. So people who looked at her dead now never knew that she had such a wonderful visions. And they also did not know that she had gone to God and now she is with God enjoying the joy. If only they knew it, most probably they must have felt jealous of her. What a wonderful girl. What a death she had, they would have said. But nobody knew about the visions. Nobody knew. Nobody know about the joys that she's enjoying at present being with God. The heavenly joy and gladness of a new year. So the people are celebrating New Year, enjoying. They had the roasted goose on the previous night. Now they are enjoying. Is she happy to celebrate the New Year? Yes, she must be the happiest. And she has the best New Year than all the rest. Why? Because she is with God in heaven. She is with God in heaven.